Yeah, so I think if I was a news organization, more than anything, I would be keen to continue to experiment with technology like this that could engage my users. See, this is so easy to say, see every one of these failed experiments as a wonderful learning opportunity. In fact, the example I gave earlier with the Seattle Times using a wave on the website was not actually a super successful experiment. It started out looking really promising. I think when about 360 readers, which is not a very large number, when about 350 readers had contributed to that wave, it all turned into mush. And when you read what the journalist wrote about it, they said, you know, it was looked promising, and it all fell apart. Maybe we'll come back later. And I think we're on my team very keen to solve that problem for them. Wave right now is more about small groups of people collaborating on content than very large groups of people collaborating on content. It's the same thing you were mentioning before, how journalists are very naturally reluctant to engage with their readers because you get all of these comments and there's just too many to respond to, and you don't have any really good means of finding the high quality ones. And that's something I think technology can actually do for you if you're willing to continue to experiment. Just like, so Google obviously made its company around the ability to sort through enormous amounts of information when a user goes and asks for something on the internet. And there's no reason why technology shouldn't also help you in this particular case, sorting through 1,000 million comments from large numbers of readers and find the good ones, where good you would define as the ones where the most people would benefit from me responding to those comments. We actually have a tool at Google, pardon the plug, called Google Moderator that does exactly that sort of thing. If you happen to be in the news, I encourage you to look at it. It's a very simple thing where lots of users can come and ask a question. And then when the next user comes, in addition to being able to ask a new question, you also get to vote on a random sampling of previously asked questions. And at the end of a little bit of time, the good questions tend to bubble to the top. I think we actually use the same algorithm that we use for picking good ads next to search results.
There'd be an algorithm in there somewhere.
Oh, there's definitely an algorithm one. But it's an algorithm that really tries to get the best out of, well, crowdsourcing. It's just one example of how if you keep experimenting, eventually we'll find the right way to have these kind of engagements. And I think someone mentioned earlier on the floor here the problem of attention span, right? There's so much information, and we end up getting all of these little sound bites. And I think the only answer I can think of to that is more engagement. I think if we can really find a way to actively engage the consumers of news, then I think that's where the attention span might actually start increasing again.